So now we're going to work on some groups that not all books make you know, but your book does. So we're going to go ahead and go over them just to be safe. All right? So acyl chloride. Acyl chloride, you can think of it like an aldehyde, but instead of having an H, it has a Cl. Okay? And the acyl chloride has a condensed structure of basically RCOCl. Okay, so if you ever see that, that's an acyl chloride. We're not going to work with these a lot in Orgo 1, okay? We're actually not going to see these again until Orgo 2. We're going to work with them a lot, okay? But it's cool. It's good that you guys know these ahead of time. Then you've got another one that has to do with carbonyls, and that's anhydride, okay? So an anhydride is a little bit tricky. Think of it almost like an ether, ROR, but instead of having just R groups, it has carbonyls on both sides, okay? So it turns out that the way to name an anhydride through condensed structure is pretty tricky. The way that, I mean, sometimes it's just listed out exactly the way it looks. So that would be, let's just write that out, CH3COOCOCH3, okay? So you can see that was a little bit tricky, all right? But sometimes it's also written with the O in the middle leading off, and that's the one that I happen to see a little bit more. So that would just be that you take the O, and then you have everything on both sides, since they're the same in this case, in parentheses. So then that would just be C, O, and then R, whatever R group you have. That would be this R group right here and this R group right here, times two. And that basically tells you that you have, we're splitting this thing down the middle, and we've got one of these things, and we've got the second one there, and both of them are COR. All right, so there you go, acyl chloride, anhydride. You're not gonna have to work with these too much, but maybe just recognize them for the test.